Book of Illumination. Some of the scholars who are mystical and the monks that have been forwarded to some of them to now in the 2nd century Palestine. The book is an anthology of statements. There are not one but various extreme systems of thought in the Bahir. Extremes in our likelihood as in the back of the machine that we have it in the 1st century Provence. And it's sort of started as we work in the 13th century Philadelphia. Irrespective of the divinity that there are different, including ways of describing God, the subsequent history of the way the text was read is such that it was thought to be promoting the doctrine of the divine made up of ten powers and appointments which he wrote, but also identified by the events known as the Palestinians, the means of which the Lord was created. Perhaps most importantly in the Bahir is the emphasis placed on viewing the divine as being both male and female, and understanding that the unity of the Godhead consisted of a pairing, a conjunction of these two different aspects. That later travelers would refer to as the secret of the underdog and the third group of the same. This grant is said in contrast to the reveal the divine unity that has been promoted at the same time by a figure like Nehunia, who has understood that unity as being specifically to demand any possibility of such bodily thoughts or attributes. So that the Kabbalistic idea promoted by the Bahir in the subsequent Congress strikingly opposes this view and understands the unity in the dynamic and organic fashion, and primarily related to the structural implications of the divine for man and human. Also, highly important is the fact that the Bahir authors or the adopters of the Bahir text Kabbalists and Provence attacked this emphasis on the erotic and sexual symbolism of the divine to the identity spirit. So that, for instance, Sabbath is understood in the Israel constitution as being representative of this holy union between the male and the female, the female being the eve of Sabbath and the male being the day of Sabbath. But, for instance, the philosophy they understood as embodying the same secret, the own philosophies corresponding to the female and the her philosophies to the male. But for instance, the community could take a certain shape in a convent in the festival of tabernacles to church, and again understood the concerns of the serpent union of the male and female aspect of the divine. This combination of sexual symbolism and meaning to ritual and the community impact in the development of such a deep today remains close to history, even if we do the most of it. But the Book of Illumination, which some of the scholars who are mystical and the monks that have been forwarded to some of them to now in the 2nd century Palestine. The book is an anthology of statements. There are not one but various extreme systems of thought in the Bahir. Extremes in our likelihood as in the back of the machine that we have it in the 1st century Provence. And it's sort of started as we work in the 13th century Philadelphia. Irrespective of the divinity that there are different, including ways of describing God, the subsequent history of the way the text was read is such that it was thought to be promoting the doctrine of the divine made up of ten powers and sentences with the work, but also identified by the events and things from the beginning of his career that created. Perhaps most importantly in the year is the emphasis placed on viewing the divine as being both male and female, and understanding that the unity of the Godhead consisted of a plan, a convention of these two different aspects that later Pavlov would refer to as the secret of the underground and the third difference between. This grounds is said in contrast to instance to the view of divine unity that has been promoted at the same time by a figure like Maimonides, who would have understood that unity as being simplicity with the knowledge and the possibility of such bodily thoughts or attributes. So that the Kabbalistic idea promoted by the Bahir in the subsequent centuries strikingly opposes this view and understands the unity and the dynamic and the dynamic statement and primarily related to the structural implications of the divine for human beings. Also, highly important is the fact that the Bahir authors or the adopters of the Bahir text, Kabbalists and Provence, attacked this emphasis on the erotic conceptual symbolism of the divine to the identity spirit. So that, for instance, Sabbath is understood in its very constitution as being